First we have to select a new assembly port. Here we are going to insert the component which we have created previously. So go to the insert components, browse our components, choose our corresponding component and place it at a required position. Then we need to insert one more component. So browse our component and place it at a required positions. Now we are inserting two components successfully. Our first component is created by using swipe boss feature. Our second component is created by a revolve feature. In our first component, we have a path for a swipe boss. So you have to show the path for a assembly purpose. In our second component, we need to create a vertex point. So make sure you have a vertex point in your revolve feature. If you not create a vertex point, the advanced mate cannot be applied here. So we need here two things, one is path, another is a point. Then we are going to the mate and select a advanced type mate. Inside the advanced type mate, we have to select a path mate. Select a path mate. Then drag the dialog box. First we have to select a component vertex. Drag our design tree. In a revolve feature, we have a point. So just click a point as a vertex component. Just select a point. Then we need to select a path selection. Path selection is nothing but it is a path of swipe boss feature. So select a path in a swipe boss feature. Now the path mate is successfully applied here. We can change the path constraints based upon your requirement. Just select a path constraint as a distance along path. We can specify the distance value. Just enter our required distance value in terms of inches. The ball shifted feature can be moved according to your distance. Now we are entering the 6 inches. The path will be correspondingly based upon the revolve feature. Now the path mate is successfully completed. Thanks for watching. Inshallah, we will meet in next video.